Hello subscriber and viewer, once again I came back in tutorial number 4. Okay, so in this tutorial we will see how to use variable in Qbasic. In the last tutorial we had seen about the variable, but now in this tutorial we will practically see how we can implement variable in Qbasic programming. So just going into next slide. First, we will see some points which are related with the variable declaration. Okay, once you know this point, you can easily use variable in program. So first point is start with letters. Okay, means whatever the variables are there, they will start with variable. They will start with letter only, like A, B, C. They will not start with number or special symbol. Second point, special symbol are not allowed. Means while declaration of variable, you may not use any special symbol like question mark, ampersand, whatever it is. No spacing will be there. And it will be short and meaningful. Means whatever the variable you will use, it will be short and it will be meaningful. So that if your program will become long, even though you will not get confusion about your declaration of variable. Last point is string variable name end with dollar. Means if you are using string variable name, it must end with dollar. String variable name means the variable must have character or it may have some number also. So, as a beginner, I think you will get some confusion about all these points. So, we will directly use all these points which are related with the variable in program. Okay. So, first point, again I repeat, start with letter. Okay. So, I just minimize my presentation and we will directly implement all these points in program. So, I just minimize it. Now here we start our software Qbasic. Now you see our first point again, start with letter. Okay, it means suppose if we declare variable like let a equal to 10. In this declaration you see let a variable name, a is variable name, and declaration always start with let, L-E-T. So a is variable name. So variable we use for giving some initial value. So value of variable is 10. Now we use print a. What will happen here? It will show the value of a. Okay, so we will just see the output. Run command and start. Till then we will revise starts with letter. So our output is coming 10. So here you see our output is 10 because the value of a was 10. So it means you can declare the variable like this. Okay. But the condition is it must start with letter. Suppose we write 1a, now it start with digits. So you see here error is coming. Expected operator in equation on current line means it is not accepting. It means it always starts with letter. Second point, special symbol not allowed. Now here I am writing special symbol like percent. So you see, again the error is coming. Okay. So in short, for avoiding any confusion, you should not use special symbol. Okay. But in QBasic, if suppose after later, if you are using special symbol, it is accepting. But it is advisable not to use special symbol for avoiding any confusion. No spacing. Suppose I am writing variable a comma b, taking error. Okay, so you cannot use space in between two letters. Means the space not allowed while declaration of variable. Next point is short and meaningful. You should always write short. Here I have written short a, or at least you write meaningful. Suppose you are doing addition of two number, then your first variable like number 1, second variable like number 2. So either you use meaningful variable or short. String variable name ends with dollar. If you are using string data, it should end with dollar, like this. It is dollar. Here it is showing error. Error is what? Illegal string number, because we are using digits here, not string value. So for giving string value, you always write in double quote. Inside it you can write anything, no problem. So if you run this program, again it will show error, because here also you should write a dollar. Then finally you can run it, no problem here. Start. And you, whatever the value you have declared here in double quote, that value you will get in output. Okay. So that is what string value you see. Same thing you are getting here. Close it. So once again you remember, whenever you use value in double quote, that is known as string value. And whatever the variable is there, it must end with dollar. And if you are using simple variable, means it is taking suppose number, then you should not use dollar. Okay. For example, if I want digits 10, then what changes should be there in program? Simply remove dollar. Here also, in second line also you remove dollar. It will work, no problem. Here you will get the value 10. Let's see for your confirmation. Here your output should be 10. Got it? Here 10 is only coming. So in this way, in this tutorial, you understood how you can use the variable in program. Okay. So I hope you understood this tutorial, and after this, you should see the next tutorial also. And please subscribe my channel.